Hi, I'm Kurt Lamon and I'm in the shop today. We're going to be doing a little plastics identification with you guys. As you can see here, I've got a bumper. The backside of the plastic is yellow. It's a very common plastic from the 1970s, 80s, and 90s. Polyurethane. Thermoset polyurethanes are very common, and it's the only bumper plastic that is yellow. So when you see the backside and it's yellow, you know that it's thermoset polyurethane. Here, we've got a classic Porsche bumper. As you can see, it's black, like many of today's bumpers. Most of today's bumpers are polypropylene, and if you were to look at this bumper, seeing that it's black, you might think, oh, this is polypropylene also. But you'd be wrong. This is also thermoset polyurethane. So, if you see that the bumper plastic is yellow, you know it's urethane. But not all urethanes are yellow. And this is a Toyota bumper from the 90s, early 2000s, that's a light gray, and it's also polyurethane. If we zoom in on the ID symbol, it'll say PUR, polyurethane. This Porsche bumper, again, it's black, is a polyurethane, but it doesn't have the ID symbol on it. Back in the 80s, they didn't have to put the ID symbol on the plastic. So how do we identify it? A couple ways. We can lay a hot welder tip on the backside. If it's polyurethane, it'll smoke and bubble immediately. And after it's cool, that area that you tried to melt will stay sticky. That indicates that you've broken down the chemicals of the plastic. Another way to do it is to take a high-speed sanding disc and lay into it. A polyurethane will dust up, kind of like you're sanding body filler. Whereas if you do the same thing on a TPO or polypropylene bumper, it will smear. Actually, the friction heat will melt the plastic and the plastic will smear. So, as you can see, polyurethane comes in a variety of colors. Normally, you'll see it in yellow, sometimes in black or gray, but now you know how to identify urethane and take a look at Polyvance's training resources to find out how to repair it.